Hello, welcome to the session on basics of signals. Signals constitute an important part of our daily life. On a day-to-day basis, we come across different types of signals like electrical signals, TV signals, speech signals, and so on. So what is actually a signal? Anything that carries information can be called a signal. It is the mathematical representation of a physical quantity or variable which carries some information. Signals can be represented in the graphical format like this, in which the x-axis and y-axis can be represented using the independent variable and dependent variable. The x-axis will always denote the independent variable, while the y-axis will always represent the dependent variable for a signal. Types of signals. Based on the number of independent variables, signals can be classified into three, that is one-dimensional signals, two-dimensional signals, and multi-dimensional signals. One-dimensional signals, if the signal is depending upon only one independent variable, then it is called one-dimensional signal. For example, ECG, that is the electrocardiography. Two-dimensional signal, the signal depends upon two independent variables, then it is called a two-dimensional signal. An example of a two-dimensional signal is a picture signal or an image in pixels, like its function consists of the x and y coordinates. Both dimensions are considered, hence it is a two-dimensional signal. Multidimensional signal, if the signal depends upon more than two independent variables, then it is called multidimensional signal. An example for multidimensional signal is tomographic space images as well as static grayscale plane image. Classification of signals. Based upon the nature and characteristics of the signal in the time domain, it is classified into two, that is continuous time signals and discrete time signals. Continuous time signals, it is otherwise known as analog signals. Here, the independent variable is time, denoted by the letter T. The signal is represented as x of t. It is continuous in amplitude as well as time. That is, both dependent and independent variables are continuous in nature. Discrete time signals, it is defined only at discrete intervals of time. This signal is continuous in amplitude but discrete in time. That is, the independent variable is discrete while the dependent variable is continuous. Here, the independent variable is time itself, but it is denoted as n. The signal can be represented as x of nt or x of n, where n is the integer. Discrete time signals. Discrete time signals are classified into two, that is, it can be either inherently discrete signal or a continuous time signal converted to a discrete time signal. An example for inherently discrete signal is shown here, where the independent variable is taken as time in years, and the dependent variable is the number of students. The x of n discrete signal is shown here. We can clearly see that it is inherently discrete in nature. Second one is the continuous time signal converted to a discrete time signal. Here a voltage versus time continuous signal is given here, which is x of t is then converted to x of n. Now, how is a digital signal different from a discrete signal? Digital signals can assume only particular values like ones and zeros, while a discrete signal can assume any value. In case of a digital signal, both dependent and independent axes are quantized, while in case of discrete signals, only the dependent axis is quantized. From this figure, we can see that analog signals can be converted into a time discrete signal through sampling, and this discrete time signal is further converted to a digital signal through quantization process. Another method is by converting the analog signal into a quantized signal by the quantization process itself, and then converting this quantized signal into a digital signal by sampling. An analog signal can be converted into a discrete signal by the process of sampling. Next is the representation of discrete time signals. Discrete time signals can be represented in the following methods, the first one being graphical representation. For example, consider a signal x of n with values x of minus 2 equal to 5, x of minus 1 equal to 2.2, x of 0 equal to 1, x of 1 equal to minus 2, x of 2 equal to 3, x of 3 equal to 2, and x of 4 equal to 1.5. It is represented graphically as this figure, where n is equal to minus 2, it is 5, n is equal to minus 1, it is 2.2, n equal to 0, it is 1, n equal to 1, it is minus 2, n equal to 2, it is 3, n equal to 3, it is 2, and n equal to 4, it is 1.5. Next is the functional representation. In case of a functional representation, the values of x of n are shown in a curly bracket. That is, like x of n is equal to 5 for n equal to minus 2, 2.2 for n equal to minus 1, 1 equal to it is equal to 1 for n equal to 0, minus 2 for n equal to 1, 3 for n equal to 2, 2 for n equal to 3, and 1.5 for n equal to 4. Third one is the tabular representation. Here the first row represents n, while the second row represents x of n. Here when n equal to minus 2, it is 5, n equal to minus 1, it is 2.2, n equal to 0, it is 1, n equal to 1, it is minus 2, n equal to 2, it is 3, n equal to 3, it is 2, and n equal to 4, it is 1.5. The sequential representation, that is the fourth method, can be written like this inside a curly bracket itself, but x of n is equal to inside the curly bracket 5, the values of x of n, that is 5, 2.2, 1, minus 2, 3, 2, and 1.5. Here an arrow mark is used to represent the n equal to 0 term. It is really useful to use this arrow mark while drawing the discrete time signals. Thank you.